An extensive inspection of California's levees raising questions tonight about the standard of maintenance of the levees across our area.
There's a concern of underseepage through sandy materials under the levee.
Sacramento is the most at-risk metropolitan area for flooding.
Yeah, it is going, and look at the water just raging, and that is heading towards homes.
Across the nation, man-made mounds of dirt or concrete, commonly called levees, surround waterways, farmland, and cities, helping control the flow of water and reduce the risk of flooding for millions of people. In California's Central Valley, there are as many as 6,500 miles of levees. Levees are an extremely important part of the region's flood risk reduction system. But like all infrastructure, without continual inspection and maintenance, they are guaranteed to fail.
There are four primary reasons why levees fail. They include seepage, stability, erosion, and height. A seepage levee failure involves water literally seeping through the levee or the levee foundation. A stability failure involves a section of levee sloughing off because of water up against the levee. There are numerous types of erosion failures, but what's prevalent on the Sacramento River flood control system is toe erosion steepening the slope such that it's unstable to the point of collapse and inundation. And then there's levee height. When you get more flow than what they're designed for, oftentimes leads to a levee failure because of water spilling over the top of the levee.
Many California levees were constructed more than 100 years ago, often by non-engineers simply piling up dirt along a riverbank or around an area of land to stop floodwaters. Over time, without proper maintenance and improvements, and because of impacts from weather, animals, and unauthorized development, these levees became weaker and weaker. As more and more people move into the floodplains behind those levees, the risk of catastrophic flooding continues to increase.
So what do we do to fix levees to deal with those various problems? For seepage, a common fix is building a seepage cutoff wall.
A seepage cutoff wall is constructed by digging a deep trench into the middle of the levee and filling the gap with an almost watertight wall of clay or concrete.
Cutoff walls can only be constructed to about 120 feet deep. And if you're not able to tie into an impermeable layer at that depth, then we have to use a different method. And what's frequently used is a seepage berm. The intent is to extend the seepage path long enough so that the velocity of the water that's coming out is so reduced that it doesn't weaken the levee and levee foundation. Stability is dealt with by widening a levee and flattening the slopes.
Erosion is dealt with by building a layer of rock to strengthen the levee and its foundation. For height deficiencies, we construct levees higher or build a flood wall. Even after levees are improved, there will always be risk. That's why continual inspection and maintenance is required. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers sets the safety standards for levees under its authority. Local and state agencies own and maintain the levees. To find out more about levee projects in California's Central Valley, visit these federal and state websites.